filled in my eyebrows off of camera and also concealed and set my eyelids. For my eyebrows, I just used my Anastasia brow dip, and to conceal my eyes, I used my LA Girl Pro Concealer, and I just set it with a translucent powder. So for today, I wanted to try this new floating or invisible liner look that I've been seeing go around Instagram, and I kind of wanted to try it for myself to see if I was able to do it. So yeah. I don't know where I'm going with this look, so which is in the way now. This is what I came up with. This is a lot harder than what it looks. Hopefully with lashes, this whole situation will look a lot better. But you know, everything is trial and error. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and do this eye off of camera, and then I'll be back. I don't know how I feel about it. Not really. So I'm gonna be priming using my Mario Dust Goo spray. I always blend that in. Foundations. I will be mixing the Wet n Wild Photo Focus foundation. I am in Toffee Pecan, and the LA Pro Coverage foundation in bronze, I think. Yes, in bronze. Blend it in with the brush. I'm gonna go in with my beauty blender and just make everything seamless. My LA Girl Pro Concealer in Fawn and my Tarte Shape Tape. It's just to highlight a little bit in tan. Shape shape tape. Just a tad. I don't really like to go overboard with this because this is like really, really full coverage. This is just to highlight. Just a tad. Blender. I always like to go in with my brush as well. Just because that Tarte Shape Tape is more of a natural pinkish undertone, so it tends to leave that cast on my face. So I just take my foundation brush and just pass it a little bit over that area so it won't be grayish or pull off gray on my face. Translucent, my absolute favorite powder. I'll go out with this little brush and just tap off and go in lightly. I don't like to bake with this powder anymore because I get so like dry under my eyes whenever I bake with it. Like, it's the craziest thing. Under eye is set, I'm going to go in with my Wet n Wild Photo Finish Pressed Powder with the same brush that I used to set all my highlighted places. Alright, and now it's time to contour my bronze. So for my bronzer, I am switching it up and I'm going to use this NYX Matte Bronzer. The new product I said I wanted to go in with was this TARDIS Pro Glow To Go. I got this in Sephora, the little kiosk thing that was, you know, that they get you with at the end. I'm going to go in with this because they have like this really like grayish color down here. I'm going to see if I can contour with it, but I'm really scared of it. I'm gonna take this same contour and I'm gonna go in with this little brush and I'm gonna do my nose. So now we're gonna go in and work on that bottom lash line. Really tiny, tiny, precise brush. This is usually like the most difficult part for me because if you knew my channel, you wouldn't know, but I had surgery on this eye, on my left eye, your right, when I was in 12th grade, and I have my scar right here, literally right where I'm passing my brush. And it is the most sensitive part. Like, if your eyes are sensitive, look, this is to like another extreme. Just because I have my scar there, it's the worst. Secrets little brush. I'm gonna go into this AliExpress Huda Beauty palette in Angelic and tap off the excess, and I'm gonna use that in my inner corner. These are like my favorite lashes. Like, I literally have to retire them, but I just love them so much that I refuse to give them up until I know for sure that they jacked up and I need to give them up. And I also went ahead and applied my Too Faced lip injection just to pop my lips up, get them a little ready for, you know, delete. I'm feeling a little like flat, so I'm gonna go back in with my NYX bronzer. I'm gonna just add a little more to my cheeks because I like being like severely bronzed. We're just gonna go ahead and add some mascara on the bottom of the lashes, and I'm gonna go in with my L'Oreal Telescopic, my all-time favorite. Our mascara is on. All that's left to do is highlighter. Now, before I highlight, I always like to go in with my Mario Fresco. It takes away a lot of the powderiness from obviously all the powder and products that we put on our face. So if you're someone like me that you tend to look ashy because of all the powders that you apply, this is a good tip. I'm gonna go in with this little travel size opal highlighter from Becca. I picked this up at Sephora, and I'm gonna go in with my Morphe 501, my Morphe M501. Let's go with the lip. We're gonna go in with this random beauty supply retractable liner. And then we're gonna top it off with these two AliExpress dots of colors, with these in cork and look. Now you guys saw that I struggled, like your girl struggled to get this liner, but it's all trial and error. The more you practice, obviously, the better you get. Now, as I mentioned earlier, now that I'm more familiar with the idea of it, all I gotta do is just perfect my technique, and that's nothing that practice won't fix. So I was thinking I shouldn't post this, but you know what, like, everybody has their days where they're like everybody has an off day, and this is something that is way out of my comfort zone, and it's like I wanted to film this, so you know, I just pushed through it. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. Please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe for more videos, let me know down below what you guys want to see from me next, and yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed.